The Mr. Excel podcast is brought to you by Easy Excel.
Did you see it? Did you see my Twitter announcement? May 12th. That's the date. Microsoft's going to release Office 2010, May 12th. Time is flying. I need to review all those chapters. Today's podcast, I'm not actually going to be in Excel. I'm going to be in a browser. I want you to go out to Windows Live, sign up for a Windows Live account, come over here to More, choose something called SkyDrive, 5 gigabytes of storage. On your SkyDrive, I want you to upload an Excel 2007 file to your SkyDrive, okay? And then once it's up there, you'll see something kind of cool where you can go in and say that you want to view, right? And you can actually see your spreadsheet on a browser. It is pretty amazing what you can do when you choose view. I have a pivot table here, I have a chart, I have some slicers. Watch what happens when I change the slicers. This is all happening in a browser, not using Excel at all. The pivot table updates, the chart updates. Now what you need to do here is you need to poke around and you're going to see a link to something about a beta version where you can actually edit this. All right, so it's not obvious. You have to click around and find it. But then you're going to be able to do something called edit in browser. This is brand new in Office 2010. You can get to Word, PowerPoint, and Excel web versions of those. So you can take data from Excel, save it up to your SkyDrive, and then when you're at home, even if you don't have Excel at home, you can come in here, edit in browser, and you can do basic data entry and create new formulas, and so equal to raised to the third power, and it calculates. It's very, very cool. Now you don't have everything. You have the home tab, you have the insert tab, and a few things on the file tab. Basically, as soon as you do an entry, it automatically saves. So, you know, where's the save button? What it saves every time you could go, and you can even have multiple people editing on the web at the same time. So something that we've just really have not been able to do at all in Excel for quite some time. It is amazing just how Excel-like this is. This is a browser. I'm in a browser, and I'm using something that feels an awful lot like Excel. Now, I can't create new pivot tables here. I can't create new array formulas here, but the pivot tables that already exist work. The array formulas that already exist work. I can use the 360 functions or whatever. So this is extremely cool. Something new that's coming in Excel 2010, and if you poke around out there, set up a live account, and then set up a SkyDrive, get an Excel file up there, you'll eventually see that link that will let you try this out. Now, if you get Windows Live, go ahead and try and connect to me, pub@MrExcel.com. I have a series of documents that I've shared out here, public Excel web tests and public read-only. If you go into Excel web tests, you can actually edit the guest book and go in, just say that you were there, or try out some of these other things that I have out there. Very, very cool feature coming in Excel 2010, seamless integration with Excel 2010, being able to do file, save to the SkyDrive. You get 5 gigabytes up there. Now, I've heard some people outside of the US, they're worried because this is basically saving encrypted data crossing the border into the US, which is a violation of some U.S. treaty or something like that. But if you're in the U.S., a very cool way to go. The data can be shared with either everyone, like this folder, or private, or only for people that you invite. Check it out. A great new tool in Office 2010. Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.